to build a computer. Although the PC we built in 2018 could edit YouTube videos without any big hiccups, I am now planning to do live coding sessions for which we need a PC with dedicated graphics card and one that also supports triple monitor setup in Hackintosh. Let's start with the configuration and then I'll share my build experience. We initially planned to get a Core i7-9700K, but that was just a little too expensive, so we decided to go with an i5-9600K. Both the i7 and i5 were released in the fall of 2018, and the i5-9600K is clocked at 3.7 GHz, where the i7 was 3.6 GHz. But as we already know, the i7 comes with 8 core, 8 threads, while the i5 has only 6 cores and 6 threads. At the time of making this video, Ice Lake or 10th generation processors were out, but we wanted support for Hackintosh, so we intentionally took a 9th generation chip. When it comes to motherboards, we're with ASUS again, as I really like their boards. We plan to overclock the build, so 8 series motherboards aren't gonna do. The Z390 chipset is perfect for this build, as it is easy for overclocking. One thing I was looking for in the motherboard was the availability of 2 NVMe M.2 slots, as I have macOS and Linux on NVMe M.2 SSDs, while Windows is on a SATA SSD. The ASUS ROG Strix Z390F motherboard was the perfect choice for this. Now that we have talked about overclocking, the stock Intel coolers are a no-go. I've always wanted to get an NZXT Kraken cooler, but at the end we decided to go with Deepcool Game Storm Castle 240 RGB V2. As this is my first liquid cooler, I don't have much experience with installing them, and water on electronics made me a bit concerned. With some help from my dad, I got it installed. Now let's talk about graphics card, which is the main part of the build. A lot of people recommended me to get an Nvidia card, as their encoders are more stable. I didn't go the Nvidia route for two reasons. One, Nvidia didn't open source the Linux driver. And two, newer versions of macOS don't support Nvidia cards out of the box. With a bit of research, I found out that AMD Radeon RX 580 works out of the box with macOS. I have seen people using this graphics card with dual monitors, so I was confident it would work without any issues for the triple monitor setup. RAM is where we had to take a step back. Although we planned to get 16 or 32 GB, the budget didn't really allow. We had to go with 8 GB of DDR4 RGB RAM clocked at 3200 MHz. It's an ADATA XPG Spectrix D60G 16 GB as a single stick. Linux and macOS are my most used operating systems, so they get to have an NVMe M.2 SSD of 256 GB. Windows is only used when I'm making a video that requires it, so it will get a 256 GB SATA Samsung Evo SSD. When I'm working with projects, I often switch between Linux or macOS, so we need another SSD where we can clone Git projects, and the drive should be visible and modifiable in all operating systems. This drive is formatted in either XFAT or UDF to achieve that. After all, I have been wanting to get a white cabinet from a long time. White cabinets are nostalgic and modern at the same time, plus the RGB lightings look better with white cases. We went with NZXT H510 mid-tower case, and gotta say, it has a great build quality. In my previous build, we had Corsair VS550 for the power supply. There are two problems for not taking the same power supply once again. This time we need more than 550 watts due to the graphics card, and VS550 is a bronze rated one. So we went with Corsair TX750M. Now this is a semi-modular power supply, meaning except the 24-pin ATX connector, everything else is detachable. And this power supply is gold rated, meaning it outputs a more stable stream of current. Once put together, creating the installer went pretty smooth, but at the end of installation, macOS Catalina would fail. After a bit of research, I found out that Z390 chipset doesn't provide native NVRAM with Clover and macOS, so I had to use a custom pre-compiled DSDD patch. After installing the patch, macOS installs just like it would on a real Apple computer, and I have not faced any stability issues from then. Things like sleep and updates that don't work properly in most Hackintoshes work flawlessly. So that was it for this video. Please subscribe and hit the bell icon for more videos like this. This is Vasant Developer, signing off.